Happy New Year.
Happy New Year.
This is the day the Lord has made. Let's rejoice and be glad in it. Thank you. Great. And it's also the seventh day of Christmas. Now, so Christmas isn't over yet, but welcome to all of you. Glad to see you here this morning on this bright and chipper day. A little cool, but it'll keep you moving. The only announcements that I know of at this point is that we want to thank all of you for having the poinsettias decorating our service today and before, and you're also welcome to take those home with you if you'd like to do that today. The only other thing that I have is that I do want to mention to you that Manchester United Methodist Church has again paid 100% of our apportionment for the 2016 year. So we can be proud of that. So thank you all very much. And that is in addition to all of the local mission work that we did here in Manchester and for around the world. Today's mission, January, is UMCOR. And we did UMCOR last year, and very well. We jumped it really good. The conference was thankful to us for what we did for UMCOR. So thank you very much for that. And shall we begin worship?
Lord of life, Lord of all. Let us pray. Loving God, help us remember the birth of Jesus, that we may share in the song of the angels, the gladness of the shepherds, and worship of the wise men. Amen. Now please all join together in our opening hymn, Good Christians, Friends, Rejoice, number 224 in the hymnal. The Lord be with you.
Also with you.
Let us pray. Lord, how do we share your image in this world?
By the Spirit
of love, joy, peace,
forbearance, kindness, goodness, faithfulness, gentleness, and self-control. Why are these important?
Against
such things there is no law. How is this possible? By the Spirit. Amen. Now we have the passing of the peace. The peace of Christ be with you.
And also with you.
As we have received grace and love in Jesus Christ, let us share Christ's peace with one another.
Maybe see. Whoops. Didn't mean to scare anybody this morning. Our scripture today comes from Psalms 39, 7, and 8. But now, Lord, what do I look for? My hope is in you. Save me from all my transgressions. Do not make me the scorn of fools. And then we have 1 Corinthians 13. If I speak in the tongues of men or of angels, but do not have love, I am only a resounding gong or a clanging cymbal. If I have the gift of prophecy and can fathom all mysteries and all knowledge, and if I have a faith that can move mountains, but do not have love, I am nothing. If I give all I possess to the poor, and give over my body to hardship that I may boast, but do not have love, I gain nothing. Love is patient, love is kind. It does not envy, it does not boast. It is not proud. It does not dishonor others. It is not self-seeking. It is not easily angered. It keeps no record of wrongs. Love does not delight in evil, but rejoices with the truth. It always protects, always trusts, always hopes, and always perseveres. Love never fails. But where there are prophecies, they will cease. Where there are tongues, they will be stilled. Where there is knowledge, it will pass away. For we know in part, and we prophesy in part. But when completeness comes, what is in part disappears. When I was a child, I talked like a child. I thought like a child. I reasoned like a child. When I became a man, I put the ways of childhood behind me. For now we see only a reflection as in a mirror. Then we shall see face to face. Now I know in part. Then I shall know fully, even as I am fully known. And now these three remain, faith, hope, and love. But the greatest of these is love.
Children, can you come up together? You can stand if you can stand if you'd like. Thank you for coming. We have something new today that is going to be a little different than what you've had before. But we're going to ask the congregation to tune in on this as well, because we're going to sing. Have you heard of the 12 Days of Christmas? Do you know the 12 Days of Christmas? Well, these are just a little different, because on the first day of Christmas, and the love that gives us is really God. So we will use the word God. So the first day of Christmas, God gave to me Jesus. Can we do Jesus when we say that, when we sing that? We're gonna do that. The second day of Christmas, God gave to us the testaments. Can you see it up on the screen? So, congregation, you get to sing in on this too. They're not going to be doing it alone. On the third day of Christmas, God gave to me the three of virtues, faith, hope, and love, which Jean's just mentioned in the scripture reading. And the fourth day of Christmas, God gave us the four gospels. So can we remember to do those? And we'll start with number one, we'll go up to four, and we'll just repeat it like we do for 12 days of Christmas. So, on the first day of Christmas, God gave to me Jesus. On the second day of Christmas, God gave to me the Old and New Testaments, Jesus. On the third day of Christmas, God gave to me the three virtues, the Old and New Testament, and Jesus. Well, at least we'll get back to Jesus. Okay, on the fourth day of Christmas, let's go with that. On the fourth day of Christmas, God gave to me the four Gospels, the three virtues, the Old and New Testament, and Jesus. Thank you. You all did great. So we'll have a chance to go over this again a little bit later, okay? Because we have 12 days for us to go through. So all of these 12 days are times for us to remember that Christmas isn't over yet. Christmas is still here, and we're celebrating the seventh day of Christmas today. And we're going to talk about more of that. So thank you very much for coming up. Remember Jesus. I apologize for the leader on the children's sermon. We had to make an adjustment last night. Thanks to Ruth, she got all of our things in line, so we did. But it's great to have the young people coming up. But all of you get the chance to sing about what God has given you on the 12 days of Christmas. We don't want you to forget that. After all, today is, yes, a new year, a new day, but it's still the 12th day of Christmas. And we want to remember that because we have Christmas all the way to Epiphany. And Epiphany will be on January 6th. Now, January 6th and Epiphany was an easy date for us to remember in my family, my immediate family, because my brother's birthday was on January 6th. So we celebrated, yes, but we had celebrated Christmas, and we had all of the Christmas gifts that we opened and that sort of thing. But during the Epiphany, which was really his birthday, we celebrated that Christ had come and that the Magi, the three kings, were here. They have now arrived, bringing gifts to the child that had just been born in Bethlehem. So my brother got to open gifts on that day as well, in addition to his Christmas gifts that he had a few days earlier. But that's fine. We can remember that day of Epiphany, and we'll be celebrating that day of Epiphany as the day that the kings have come. We celebrate Christmas with singing. And with this song, The 12 Days of Christmas, we can actually celebrate Christmas on the 12th for the 12 days. Now, back in the early, about 16th century, before I was even born, there were people who decided that this should be a time for young people to learn more about the Christian faith that they lived. And it was important for them to know ways of celebrating the faith. And this was one way that they used for the 12 days of Christmas, just as we did just the four, that true love that gives us the partridge in the pear tree is really God giving us Jesus who died on the tree. So we tie that together, and the young people remember this, that's how we do. Each of the days does represent some aspect of the Christian faith. So through our self-revelation in the Bible, our true love, the author of love is God. And the seven gifts of the Holy Spirit we'll come to also. But the first day of Christmas is Jesus. And we want to remember Jesus as he comes. The 7 days of Christmas, we have the seven gifts of the Holy Spirit. So we will want to remember those seven gifts as being prophecy, ministry, teaching, exhortation, giving, leading, and compassion. As early as the Old Testament, Isaiah mentioned in Isaiah 11, 1-5, he said, "A shoot will come up from the stump of Jesse. From his roots a branch will bear fruit. The Spirit of the Lord will rest on him, the Spirit of wisdom and of understanding, the Spirit of counsel and might, the Spirit of knowledge and fear of the Lord, and he will delight in the fear of the Lord." Now, the fear of the Lord really wasn't a scary thing, as some of us may have heard in previous years, the preachers that really give a sermon that makes you fear. This is really that we want to be in awe over Jesus coming for us. That's the fear that we have, is that it's unbelievable that God is able to send his son to us. But righteousness in all of this will be his belt and faithfulness, the sash around his waist. And Isaiah is still saying that. And let me just mention also that in 1 Corinthians 12, 7-11, in the New Testament, we have also about the Spirit. "Now to each one, the manifestation of the Spirit is given for the common good. To one, there is given through the Spirit a message of wisdom, to another, a message of knowledge by means of the same Spirit, to another, faith by the same Spirit, to another, gifts of healing by that Spirit, to another, miraculous powers, to another, prophecy, to another, distinguishing between spirits, to another, speaking in different kinds of tongues, and to still another, the interpretation of those tongues. All of these are the work of one and the same Spirit, and he distributes them to each of us just as he determines. So it's important for us in this time to remember that the Spirit is with us, all around us, in all that we do, in all that God wants us to do. The Spirit is filling us. And it's time for us to get involved with the Spirit and know that the Spirit is in us. The Spirit is in us. Now, one of the things that was mentioned in here is about wisdom. Now, the parables, Proverbs is one of the ways for us to gain wisdom through the Bible. And in the Bible, that's important for us to continually know and to search for things for us to gain wisdom and knowledge. It's also a way of understanding exactly how God really wants us to live. His word, his words, we often say the word of God, it's really the words of God, is there for us to study, for us to gain knowledge, to gain understanding, for us to know what we are about, all of us, as children of God, as brothers and sisters. We are here to help each other gain in the knowledge of Christ. Fear of the Lord is not something that we need to do. We can know that it is awesome. I seldom use that word, but it is awesome to think that we have Jesus sent here for us. We've celebrated his birth, but unfortunately for us, or fortunately, we may be sad about the way that he was treated and how he died on the cross. But the important thing is that he died for us. He came for us. And in that manger, when he was born, it seems incredible that Mary was able to look down at that child, that she knew she was going to have that child. It was God's child. But when she looked down on Jesus, she was able to look down and see the face of God. She didn't just see a baby. She saw the face of God. God coming to us in one, as Pastor says, with skin on. But it was a time for Mary to be joyful to know that that was the face of God that she was looking down on. I think it's important for us in the seventh day of Christmas, since today is that seventh day, the knowledge that we've gained through the Word of God, it is important for us to understand that it's still time. We aren't finished with Christmas yet. It's time for us to celebrate that birth and to gain these things that are mentioned in the 7 days of Christmas. And again, I repeat, on the seventh day, God gave us, and it's in Romans and Corinthians, in case you, 1 Corinthians, in case you want to seek the Word of God, prophecy, ministry, teaching, exhortation, giving, leading, and compassion. But is it fair for us just to dwell on one day? I'm going to try to get you to go through the other 12 days of Christmas. So you will get to sing along with this too as we go through. But I want to go through the 12 days first to explain some of the things that the youth were to learn or to gain from this knowledge that they had by remembering the 12 days of Christmas. On the first day of Christmas, we already talked about that. that is the partridge in a pear tree, is really Jesus Christ, the Son of God. In the song, Christ is symbolically presented as a mother partridge. And if you've all, this goes with all birds, it's not just mother partridges. But what do mother birds do when they see fear approaching? They pretend that they're wounded, they go falling off across. And that's what we have, what we gain from this one, is that she wants to pretend that she's helpless. But in the memory of the expression of Christ's sadness over the fate of Jerusalem. And he was concerned about Jerusalem. In fact, in Luke, he mentions to us, he says, "Jerusalem, Jerusalem, how often would I have sheltered you under my wings as a hen does her chicks, but you would not have it so." So he was concerned about his home, Jerusalem. So that's the first day of Christmas, is Jesus. On the second day of Christmas, it's two turtle doves, but it's really two, the Old and New Testament. Together they bear witness to God's self-revelation in history and the creation of a people to tell the story of God to the world. So in the two testaments, the Old and the New, we are able to gain that knowledge. On the third day of Christmas, it says three French hens, I think, but on the third day of Christmas, it's really the theological virtues of faith, hope, and love. And all of those are given to us again in 1 Corinthians. On the fourth day of Christmas, God gave to us the four Gospels, Matthew, Mark, Luke, John. They proclaim the good news of God's reconciliation of the world to himself in Jesus Christ. So the revelation, the reconciliation, comes to us in those Gospels. On the fifth day of Christmas, the five books of the Old Testament, known as the Torah or the Pentateuch, are Genesis, Exodus, Leviticus, Numbers, and Deuteronomy, which gives the history of humanity's sinful failure. It's really the time when we fell from grace from God to the creation of a people to be a light to the world. It became a time for Christians now to be a light to the world. It's also sometimes called the Book of Moses. On the sixth day of Christmas, God gave to us the 6 days of creation. We think of those back in Genesis 1. The 6 days of creation that confesses God as creator and sustainer of the world. The beginning of our lives as Christians. God built our world because he wanted to be with us, and we want to be with him. So let us continue to be thinking of that. Now, the seventh day of Christmas, we've talked about the seven gifts of the Holy Spirit, our prophecy, ministry, teaching, exhortation, giving, leading, and compassion. And Romans and 1 Corinthians give us all of those in our reading. On the eighth day of Christmas, it's not eight maids milking. It's really the eight Beatitudes. And all of that's a time for us and for youth and people who are studying the Bible and studying Christianity. It's an opportunity for us to remember that the eight Beatitudes are: blessed are the poor in spirit, those who mourn, the people that are meek, those who hunger and thirst for righteousness, the merciful, the heart, the pure in heart, the peacemakers, and the last one is those who are persecuted by righteousness' sake. And that comes to us in Matthew 5. On the ninth day of Christmas, God gave us the fruit of the Holy Spirit, which is love, joy, peace, patience, kindness, generosity, faithfulness, gentleness, and self-control. I think I got all of them. But it's for us to think about those that appear in Galatians 5. So all of these things, as we sing the song, the 12 days of Christmas, with these Christian pieces to it, all of it is there to remind us, to teach us, for us to gain wisdom and to follow God. On the 10th day of Christmas, God gave us the Ten Commandments. And if you can read the Ten Commandments, you shall have no other gods before me. Do not make an idol. Do not take God's name in vain. Remember the Sabbath day. Honor your father and mother. Do not murder. Do not commit adultery. Do not steal. Do not bear false witness. Do not covet. In Exodus, if we're studying this, we can find all of this in Exodus. Now, on the 11th day of Christmas, my true love, my God, gave to me the 11 faithful apostles. 11 faithful apostles. Simon Peter, Andrew, James, John, Philip, Bartholomew, Matthew, Thomas, James Bar-Alphaeus, Simon the Zealot, and Judas Bar-James. The list does not include the 12th apostle, Judas. Judas Iscariot, who betrayed Jesus in the religious to the religious leaders and to the Romans at his as Jesus was preparing for his death on the cross. That's 11. Now I ask you to grab your hymnals. Look at page 881. You may read through this as I go through. My words might be slightly different to you, but on the 12th day of Christmas, the 12 points of doctrine in the Apostles' Creed is what God gave to us, to you and to me. So if you'll look at those, I'm going to go through the 12 points of the doctrine in the Apostles. So just follow with me. Believe in God, the Father Almighty, creator of heaven and earth. That's the first one. The second point of the Apostles, I believe in Jesus Christ, his only Son, our Lord. He was conceived by the power of the Holy Spirit and born of the Virgin Mary. Number four, he suffered under Pontius Pilate, was crucified, died, and was buried. He descended into hell or the grave. Five, on the third day he arose again. He ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of the Father. Six, he will come again to judge the living and the dead. Seven, I believe in the Holy Spirit. How important was that Spirit when all of these things that the Spirit has given to us? Eight, the Holy Catholic Church. Nine, the communion of saints. 10, the forgiveness of sins. 11, the resurrection of the body. And 12, life everlasting. That Apostles' Creed is so important for us to look at parts, but it's also for us to go through it, not by skimming quickly, but maybe to look at the parts, as we are asked to do when we're studying to learn more about the Christian faith, that we do ask to go through the 12 days of Christmas. I think I've come to the point where we get to sing. And all of you get to sing. If I can remember what all of them are. The first day of Christmas, God gave to me Jesus. The second day of Christmas, he gave us the Old and New Testament. And then Jesus. Third, virtues of faith, hope, and love. The fourth is the four apostles, four gospels. Five is the Pentateuch. Six, the 6 days of creation. Seven is the seven gifts of the Holy Spirit. Eight is the eight Beatitudes. Nine is the nine fruit of the Holy Spirit. 10, the Ten Commandments. 11, the 11 faithful apostles. And 12, the 12 points of doctrine in the Apostles' Creed. So, are you ready? The youngsters are going to can lead us because they've already sung the first four. But I'm going to need help because you know I'm not a good singer on this, but let's start it anyway. With the first day of Christmas, God gave to me Jesus. The second day of Christmas, God gave to me the Old and New Testament, Jesus. On the third day of Christmas, God gave to me virtues of faith, hope, and love. Lord, Lord, oh, Jesus. On the fourth day of Christmas, God gave to me the four Gospels, the Old Testament, and Jesus. On the sixth day of Christmas, gave to me the Pentateuch, the four Gospels, the virtual gifts, the Old and New Testament, and Jesus. On the sixth day of Christmas, God gave it to me the 6 days of creation, the Pentateuch, the four Gospels, the three virtues of faith, hope, and love, and testaments, and Jesus. On the seventh day of Christmas, God gave to me three gifts, hope, four. Jesus. On the eighth day of Christmas, God gave to me eight Beatitudes, seven gifts of the Holy Spirit, the Creation, the Pentateuch, the four Gospels, the virtues of the Old New Testament, and Jesus. On the fifth day of Christmas, God gave to me the nine fruits of the Holy Spirit, eight Beatitudes, the seven gifts of the Holy Spirit, 6 days of creation, the Pentateuch, the four Gospels, the virtues of faith, hope, and the Old and New Testament, and Jesus. On the ninth day of Christmas, God gave to me the Ten Commandments, nine fruits of the Holy Spirit, eight Beatitudes, seven gifts of the Holy Spirit, 6 days of creation, the Pentateuch, the four Gospels, Old and New Testament, and Jesus. On the 11th day of Christmas, God gave to me 11 faithful apostles, 10 commandments, 9 fruits of the Holy Spirit, 8 Beatitudes, 7 gifts of the Holy Spirit, 6 days of creation, the Pentateuch, the 4 Gospels, the Old and New Testament, and Jesus. On the 12th day of Christmas, God gave to me 12 points of the doctrine, and 10 commandments, 9 fruits of the Holy Spirit, 8 Beatitudes, 7 gifts of the Holy Spirit, 6 days of creation, 3 gospels, 3 theological virtues, Old and New Testament, and Jesus. Amen. Now you have something to think about. You can open up the book, look at the words, find the words of the 12 days of Christmas. After all, today's only 7. So you have 8, 9, 10, 11, 12. You have all of those to celebrate yet, and I hope that you celebrate those well. Thank God for giving us those 12 parts of the days of Christmas. Could we pray, please? Dear God, we are so thankful that you have given us so much. The grace that you put down to us. The love that you want us to return to you. May we find in this new year and within these 12 days of Christmas that we can find a way to return so much love to you that you have given to us. Care for those around us, all around us that we love. Be with us as we go from day to day, that we may lead the world in finding peace among ourselves, among our world, that we may know that peace exists, that your love is here for us to share. We pray this in Jesus' name. Amen. Amen. Now, I think it's time, if we have any prayers for the people that any of you might share with us, all of your Christmas presents that you received this year. If you have any prayers for the people, we'd be glad to do that at this time. Leon, we're glad you're here. We're glad to be everyone is here, but I know he travels from another state. How many of others of you are traveling further from another state to be with us today? Anybody? Ah, yes. And you're skipping out on us soon, aren't you? When?
Tomorrow.
Tomorrow. Oh, my. Mother and Dad, enjoy her quickly. If not, do we have anyone? Is there a hand going up that I don't see? If not, it will soon be time for us to take communion. The sacraments are so important for us to do at this time. I'll just start the new year. And Tom will be glad to do that with us. But let us first make a prayer for the prayers of the people, if we may. Dear God, we know that there are people here. We know that there are people elsewhere. We are people that we know that you have your hand of love on touching them. We know that they need you. Please give them the love that they need, the healing powers that they need, that they may feel that you are near and that your love is overwhelming to them. We give prayers to those people who are not here that we know need your help. We look at the list that we have on our bulletin, and we say prayers to all of those people that in this day and world, we need them and they need us. And we know that, God, you need them and they need you. be with them, be with those that we do know, be with those that we do not know, but be with all of us as we go from this place. In his name we pray. Amen. Tom? Disappeared. I hope all of you know Tom. He's been here for a short time, but now we put him to work. Isn't that great? So thanks, Tom, for being here.
Thank you. Begin with the prayers of thanksgiving. The Lord be with you.
And also with you.
Lift up your hearts. Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right to give our thanks and praise.
It is right and a good and joyful thing always and everywhere to give thanks to you, Father Almighty, Creator of heaven and earth. You formed us in your image and breathed into us the breath of life. When we turned away and our love failed, your love remained steadfast. You delivered us from captivity, made covenant to be our sovereign God, and spoke to us through the prophets. And so, with your people on earth and all the company of heaven, we praise your name and join their unending hymn. Holy, holy, holy Lord, God of power and might, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest. Holy are you, and blessed is your Son, Jesus Christ. Your Spirit anointed him to preach the good news to the poor, proclaim release to the captives and recovering of sight to the blind, to set liberty to those who are oppressed, and to announce the time had come when you would save your people. You healed the sick, you fed the hungry, you ate among sinners, and by baptism of his suffering, death, and resurrection, you gave birth to your church, delivered us to slavery and to sin and death, and made with us a new covenant by water and the Spirit. When the Lord Jesus ascended, he promised to be with us always in the power of your word and Holy Spirit. On the night in which he gave himself up for us, our Lord Jesus took bread. He gave thanks to you. He broke the bread and gave it to his disciples and said, "Take, eat. This is my body, which is given for you. Do this in remembrance of me." Likewise, when the supper was over, he took the cup. He gave thanks to you. He gave it to his disciples and said, "Drink from this, all of you. This is my blood of the new covenant poured out for you and for the many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this as often as you drink it in remembrance of me." And so, in remembrance of these your mighty acts in Jesus Christ, we offer ourselves in praise and thanksgiving as a holy and living sacrifice in union with Christ, offering for us as we proclaim the mystery of faith.
Christ has died. Christ is risen. Christ will come again.
Pour out your Holy Spirit on us gathered here and on these gifts of bread and wine. Make them be for us the body and blood of Christ, that we may be for the world the body... that we may be for the world the body of Christ, redeemed by his blood. By your Spirit, make us one with Christ, one with each other, and one in ministry to all the world until Christ comes in final victory and we feast at his heavenly banquet. Through your Son, Jesus Christ, with your Holy Spirit and your Holy Church, all honor and glory is yours, Almighty Father, now and forever. And now our Savior Christ has taught us, let us pray. Our Father, communion stewards, please come forward.
motion stuff.
Thank you.
In the beginning, loving God, you spun a cosmic tale of light and dark, heavens and firmaments, teeming waters and lush gardens, all grand, each good.
And we walked in its beauty, our eyes beholding the purple sunsets, our lips tasting sweet fruits, our hands planting the tiny seed, our hearts sunning in your love. We have been truly blessed, O Lord. Ever present and ever loving God, you unveiled a cosmic star and sent a child to walk in your beauty and light the way back to you. O loving God, we praise you for your gift of Jesus, who is the light of the world, the restorer of our place at your cosmic table. And we pray, dear God, that you send your Holy Spirit now to continue to guide and abide in this, our Manchester United Methodist Church. Now please all join together in our closing hymn, Go Tell It on the Mountain. Now let your lives witness to Christ's love. Let your words bring reconciliation. Let your thoughts be of peace. Let your touch bring healing. Let your actions count for justice. Be a sign of hope and a beacon of joy. Go, and may God's blessings go with you. Amen.